native apps for Android and subsequently started with Google. Then moved on to native iOS and backend, and that's how my journey went on. The agenda for this talk would be like I'll be basically talking about the approaches we use for mobile app development, React Native, React programming model, and the core concepts of React. Brief intro about React Native, what it is, how it differs from React.js basically. Which all companies are basically using React Native for actually developing their production quality apps, right? And lastly, I'll be showing the quick setup and a quick hello world kind of short quick demo using React Native, right? So this is a very famous ongoing debate which we have usually in the mobile app development world, like should we go with native or hybrid, some cross-platform approach, right? We mostly know all the pros and cons associated with each approach we take. Most of them are very, very obvious, like when you go with some cross-platform or hybrid approach, you usually have lesser development costs and time frame. The code maintenance is comparatively easier as compared to maintaining different code bases for each separate platform. You can launch a particular app for more than one platform using cross-platform or hybrid tools, right? The obvious disadvantage is being the sluggish performance depending upon the actual approach you use. Like if you are going with phone gap code work kind of approach, your code actually runs inside a WebView. So you are kind of restricted with the WebView environment. You don't get the native feel, sleekness. Apart from it, there are the native UI UX issues which you encounter, like you want to make your app more generalized so that it caters to more than one platform. So you usually encounter UI UX issues. And it does not feel that native, that natural when it comes to using an app which is developed using native SDKs as compared to some WebView oriented frameworks, right? So how do we decide like which approach we go? Because every approach has its own advantage and disadvantage. I've been doing both development and doing business, interacting with clients overseas, developing apps for them. So from my experience, I've learned like there's no one silver bullet which fits everything. So it's not like you can say this is the only thing which will work across all kind of requirements, right? So sometimes you got to adjust yourself or propose solutions depending upon what the client is looking for or what the actual requirements are. Sometimes the requirements are very, very, like let's say possibly a game application or something which is hardware oriented. This game, such requirements will require native SDKs because those APIs won't be exposed by some cross-platform tools, right? That the obvious approach or the option would be the native SDKs, but some apps would require just, let's say, fetching data from the backend and displaying. So such normal apps can be easily developed with cross-platform tools, right? So it all boils down to knowing the actual requirement, the client with whom you are interacting, what's his budget, what's his ultimate goal, how he foresees his actual app to grow, what is his long-term plan, right? So that's how you actually propose a solution, like would a cross-platform hybrid solution fit your need or should you go with native solution? Starting with React, React is basically a JavaScript library developed at Facebook, which helps in building UI components. So React is basically a it's based on component-based architecture, only focusing on the UI part. if you have some background in web development, you'll know like boom manipulation is really, really expensive. What React, starting with what React did is it we'll go into the other concepts, but firstly how React came into existence. So React basically got inspired by XHP, which is a component based framework developed in PHP, which Facebook used for its own internal feeds and timeline projects. This guy, Jordan Bob, he basically went and spoke to his manager asking, hey, I want to bring the same concept to the client side, because what XHP was suffering was dynamic web applications have to do round trips. They have to make server requests, update data, and this cycle goes on, right? So he basically approached his manager and said, like, I want to bring the same concept to the client side. So he went ahead and tried to replicate the same model using JavaScript on the client side, and that's how React.js came into existence. React is basically declarative and component based. So when I cover with, we'll talk about the core concepts of React. So few of the main concepts being virtual DOM, the declarative components, one-way data binding, as opposed to two-way, which we find in AngularJS and other frameworks. And one of the main differences in React.js or React Native as compared to other platforms is it's learn once, write anywhere, as compared to write once, run everywhere. So virtual DOM, basically if you, I'm not sure, is the slide clear?
No.
I'm sorry.